So the results that just came out in the New England Journal of Medicine, they are interim. We have to be very clear about it. They are from the phase one. And in that phase one, this particular batch of results is from 45 adults, which weren't screened for infection. So we would call them healthy adults at this point, although we wouldn't know because no serology or polymerase chain reaction were done at the time of the enrollment. They are all adults, so they are above 18. But their cutoff is 55, so they're between 18 to 55 years old. So what they are testing at this point is two things. Of course, the phase one trials are exclusively for the safety part, so you shouldn't be having any serious side effects. So that one thing is definitely out of the door. There is no serious side effect. And you're testing the proof of the concept. So in this case, the proof of the concept is that when you are given this candidate, do you make antibody? And so that is true that they are making antibody, and the antibody response is higher with the higher dose. But this is not a test of long-term immunity at this point yet. It shows that when you give this candidate, the body makes the antibody. But whether those antibodies are effective in the body is yet to be shown, because all of the results that we have are out of the body. They are all in the in vitro, what we call in the test tube. So we need to wait for the confirmation that there is a correlation between these antibody amounts that we see in the body and that they offer a protection against the COVID-19. What we don't know is, remember I told you that this first batch of data is from 18 to 55 year old group. We do not know what the dosing will be for the older age, which you remember is the more vulnerable of the COVID-19 patient population. And the immune function of the body declines with age. So as we age, we do not produce as much antibodies, and we're not that good in producing antibody, which leads generally to the poor vaccine response. So the question is, will they have to go for a higher dose, which is usually in the case of, say, flu vaccines? So how do I feel? Good question. I feel cautiously optimistic. The study provides very promising data on the safety and immunogenicity that this mRNA candidate is good starting point for training the immunity of the body, which supports that the continued efforts towards the development of this vaccine are good. But if I can paraphrase Robert Frost, we still have miles to go before we sleep.